I'll take an order of barbecue, collard greens, and a football game.
Good afternoon, good evening, good night, good morning, wherever you are. You are now tuned into the hottest, the baddest, the greatest, and anything else you can think of, positive radio program on the air. Sir Henry Cheatham here, classic blues and R&B. We're going to be here with you until 2 a.m., playing for you the best in American music. And we hope you will be with us throughout the program to enjoy it another day, another week, another crazy week. Everything is everything, you know. Yes, yes. We're streaming live at WVON.com on the World Wide Web. We're up and running on iHeartRadio, and we also are doing our thing over here on Ustream. I never knew chocolate could look so good. I knew it always tasted good, but damn, I mean, this big old chocolate guy over here looking good, you know. You can reach us in the studio here at 773-591-1690. I want to welcome you to Classic Blues and R&B. This is where you come to get your real American music each and every week. When you enter the Classic Blues and R&B Club, you know you're at the right place. Right juke joint, right here. You get your real blues, a healthy shot of soul, and your much-needed dose of R&B, rhythm and blues. Blues, beer, and barbecue is the real American red, white, and blue. That's what you wrap yourself around. You know, you don't have to stand for that, folks. You know, you don't have to. Just enjoy it, you know. You know, that's what you do with that. And once you get here at Classic Blues and R&B, you know you found a great call letters of WVON. The call letters with a heritage and legacy, WVON 1690, coming to you here from the middle part of North America, a place we call the United States of America, Canada to the north, and Mexico is to the south. Canada has not had any tragedy this year. I think they may have had some fires, but they not had the hurricanes because they don't get it. Well, let it know. You know, the west coast of Canada, it's pretty moderate. They don't get too much of that bad weather up there. Anyway, we're back up in here again, folks. I want to say weather is on a roll again this week. Old Nate is down there in my home state. I'm the Mississippi boy, the Magnolia man. So Nate is down there raising sand. Alabama, Louisiana, New Orleans, they always this is what happened when you live on the coast, folks. This is it, your coastal state. We know, we get it, you know, nothing new about it. We've done it for many, many years. When I was a kid, we got it. You know, hurricanes, tornadoes, that's the way it is in the old tropical, semi-tropical parts of the world, of the United States. WVON wants you to get social with us by going to facebook.com/WVON1690. Follow us on Twitter at WVON1690 and on Instagram at WVON1690. You can always text WVON to 88474. So you'll be in touch with us. Classic Blues wants you to always do the same thing, too. Go to our Classic Blues Facebook. Like our Facebook page, it's Classic Blues and RB. Follow us on Twitter at WVON Henry. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Henry CB. Get out there and subscribe to us. We post and we do what we can to keep this great American music going, folks. Tell you. I don't want to see the instruments just take over. I don't want to see the artificial intelligence just take over everything. You know, just think about that. Artificial intelligence, okay? It's not real intelligence. Something somebody else put there, you know? So they still got to have people to do it, you know? I guess they put themselves out of business sooner or later. Got a guest later on here in the program. He's in the studio now warming up. He brought his, he didn't bring his band with him. I guess he brought his music down. So anyway, he's here, Mr. Huff. Steve Stone. Yeah, Steve Stone Huff is here with us. And he'll be with us here the first part here, chatting with us throughout, talking about himself and about his career and all. Saturday, October 28th is the first ever WVON Family Care Expo. It's a one-day action-packed resource fair and forum. From finances to education and healthcare, we will cover it all. Over 40 exhibitors to benefit the entire family will be on hand to help us out. Save the date, that's October 28th, and place to attend. More details are coming soon. So you just save that old date now. That's the 28th of October. Hey, welcome back, Gerald. Welcome back. had two of them, Gerald, and they didn't do it. Hey, man, I didn't know you. I said, dog, man, I said, he ain't that important. You know, turned out to be all right, man. What you got to say?
Now you see I'm the backbone of the show.
Yeah, you are. You're the backbone. What the devil am I? I don't know what I am, but thank you. Hey, Mr. Brian Peoples, will you kindly give us a call here at WVON? Brian Peoples, the number is 773-591-1690. Will you kindly give us a call, please, and chat with you about something? Okay? Appreciate that if you would do that. All right, Brian, kindly give us that call. We appreciate it. We've been waiting on you now, you know. Hope you don't hold up the show all night for us. we'd be glad to. We'd need to talk to you about something. So give us a shout, please, sir. That's 773-591-1690. How you doing, Brother Huff?
I'm doing great.
Yeah, welcome to the show. Glad to have you in the program here.
Glad to be here.
All right, you did bring me your CD, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, then. We're going to take it over there. We're going to spin it somewhere throughout the night. So you don't have to race for it, but we'll get you there, you know. You got his bodyguard with him, folks. Looking like Mr. T.
I got my muscle with
him. Yeah, looking like Mr. T. Now. Got it for nice guys. Steve Stone Huff.
Yes, sir.
It's Steve Stone Huff. So you produced everything on this track almost?
Yes, sir. Everything.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, okay, Steve Stone is he's an all-around guy, folks. Came out of the church.
Out the church.
That's where we all come from.
That's
used
right.
to be in my generation anyway. I'm glad to know that they still got some coming out of the church.
We better get back in there too.
quick. We need to be in the church, yes. Man, you know. The community, man, is one thing, and I'm telling you, you need to have some grounding, you know, some rules to play mm-hmm. by, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Seem like everything has been blended together. Children are telling grown folks and doing what grown folks do, and grown folks are doing what children. It's the other way around, you know. I'm grown, you stay over there. But now, you know, they say, hey, now you don't tell me what to do. I got as much rights as you have.
Right. Which they know more than us.
Yeah, yes, they do. They do. And I tell you, as I listen to them and look at them, man, I said, dog. The internet has made them think that they know more, but look, folks, they don't know as much as you. You so-called. Oh, happy birthday to myself too, Gerald. You didn't say happy birthday to me, man.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, well, it was Friday or Thursday.
I came in with the liquor. What you talking about?
You did bring me some cold liquor, didn't you? Yeah, but it's I to you, Miss Florence Watson, down in Memphis, Tennessee. I want to thank you for checking us out here. As you do most Saturday nights, you know, it's always good to have people listening to us. Because sometimes I think it's just Gerald and I. And hell, he don't listen too much, you know. So we're going to get into the program here. You know, you got something else you want? Oh, yeah. We're going to do this too first. We're going to play a song by one of our condolences and prayers go out to the Tom Petty family. Yeah, now, some people may not know who Tom Petty was. Tom Petty was challenging to the record company as Prince, folks. I'm telling you, you know, they went so far as to set his house on fire there in California with his family in it, man. So that's how serious they were about him, you know. And he went through some ups and downs in that doggone in the music world. You know, it is, I mean, I guess I'll tell you in a few minutes, you know, it's one of these things, you know. Even when you think you're in control, you're still not. There's always somebody who want to tell you how to be you. Am mm-hmm. I right or wrong? That's why you produce
right.
yourself,
right? Yes, you're right.
Because if I produce you, it's like that little commercial with Peyton Manning. I don't know if you've seen it or not yet. I forget the country western singer. So this guy is a musician.
Right.
You know, Peyton over there on the piano, you know. And so they kind of, you know, running some chords and things together. And the next thing you know, paid, you know, just a little bit more with a guy.
Yeah, I think I've seen it
probably,
time.
I think it was a guy called, I'm not sure, one of the spots, mm-hmm. you know, yep. All right, here we go, folks. Are you ready to do it, man, over there? Okay. You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON 1690 AM. We'll be right back.
There's someone I used to see, but she don't give a damn for me. Well, let me get to the point. Let's roll another joint and turn the radio loud. I'm too alone to be proud, and you don't know how it feels. You don't know how it feels to be me. People come, people go, some grow young, some grow cold. I woke up in between a memory and a dream. So let's get to the point. Let's roll another joint. Let's head on down the road. There's somewhere I gotta go. And you don't know how it feels. You don't know how it feels to be me. So let's get to the point. Let's roll another joint. Let's head on down the road to somewhere I gotta go. And you don't know how it feels. You don't know how it feels. No, you don't know how it feels.
Gonna tell y'all a story. Oh, about the kind of woman I need. Yeah. Let me tell y'all something. Thank you.
want a woman to understand me, one that I can gauge. I went out and found me a real young woman, one about half my age. She took me to her house and she said that I could stay. Then she turned around and threw me out the very next day. One day her love is sweet as honey, and the next day it's sour as a can of kraut. Yeah. She took me in on a Monday. Then on Tuesday, she rolled me out. I knew something was wrong that day when I walked through the door. I can tell right away the woman didn't want me around no more. I can see she was funny acting. I can tell she was sad. She started calling me pappy and throwing my clothes out of her pack. One day she's sweet as honey, the next day she's sour as a can of kraut. Yeah. She took me in on a Monday. Lots of fun. No woman, no money, and no friends. I'm back doing what I've always done. I'm on the road again. There's one thing I know. One thing I know for sure. No matter where you go, the next day she's sour as a can of kraut. Yeah. Well, she took me in on a Monday. Then on Tuesday she threw me out.
Hey Chicago, this is Ernie Isaac of the Isaac Brothers, and you're listening to Sir Henry on Classic Blues.
You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B.
On the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
Mm-hmm. won't have to run through the jungle and scuff up your feet. You just sing about Jesus and drink wine all day. Ain't it great to be in America?
bed at night. It's like making love to a dream. And when I wake up in the morning with her laying there, I have to pinch myself to make sure I'm not asleep. She all the woman and more than any man. Cooking and making love too.
Dream lover. carry diamond rings.
Baby, baby,
it's all right. Woo. I'm looking for a lover for
looking
me.
Looking for a lover. Could it be you?
And it's all
baby,
right.
It's all right.
Just looking for forever for me.
I'm looking for forever.
For me.
For me.
For me.
For me.
Branch, and you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B with Sir Henry Cheatham. The brother knows how to get down.
Saturday night with Classic Blues and R&B. I don't know if that's me or you, man. Look like everything shot up there. You just heard my man, studio guest, Steve Stone Huff, It's All Right. And before that, you heard O.B. Buchanan, Dream Lover, Gladys Wilson, Gladys Knight, Freedom for the Stallion, and Charles Wilson, Sweet and Sour Love. And of course, we opened the show program with Mr. Tom Petty. We opened it with him, and You Don't Know How It Feels. All here on Classic Blues and R&B here. All right, studio guest, we're going to chat with him now. How you doing, Brother Steve?
I'm doing great.
Good. I noticed you were patting your foot on that last song.
Yeah, I felt something. I felt something.
Yeah, you felt good.
Felt that in my bones. So, I was patting to the other stuff, too, but that one definitely stuck out.
Just moved everything. Yeah. Okay, well, welcome to Classic Blues, man. Glad to have you here.
Thank you for having me. I'm happy to be here.
Yeah, what's the name of your CD? I see. I understand you're going to have a CD release party.
Yes, at the Promontory, October 11th, this coming Wednesday from 7 to 11 p.m. Special guest is going to be Avant, which is an artist that I helped to launch in his production and songwriting, and a bunch of other guests. Rich Musical Night, you know, tickets, you can get them for $20 in advance online at promontorychicago.com, or you can pay at the door, $25 at the door. So we're going to have a good time.
Okay. What is the name of your CD?
I Promise.
That is the name of it?
That's the name of it, yeah. Okay. I Promise.
What did you promise?
I promised everything. I promised to not lie no more than
that. Why you gonna do that? You gotta lie a little bit, man. You can't tell the whole truth.
No. If you keep it real, you know.
No, you young guys don't know what real is. Real is, you don't tell them everything. You don't tell everybody everything.
Well, tell them everything is information, but truth is truth. So, I'm just saying, you know, I promise not to do what I'm probably going to do again, but at least I'm acknowledging that I'm not going to do it. I promise that because I don't want to do it again. But, you know, probably it may happen, and I just promise one more time, I'll just play the record again. You know, so however many times, you know, it takes for me to get it right.
But. Yeah, you young guys, keep it real. Hell, let me keep it real. You know, something that ain't your business. That's between God and I.
Yeah, take some to the grave, right?
There you go.
That's right.
That's exactly right. There's a whole bunch of secrets out there that you don't need to know.
Yeah,
you get
absolutely.
To help, we're going to tell it when we
get
to heaven.
You should be able to keep something for yourself.
You
always.
Definitely. Now, I've noticed that you Your daddy bought you a $50 bass. Are you a bass player?
Yes, sir. Okay, yeah.
Tell us about you.
Well, I'm a musician, bass player, a multi-musicianalist at this point, but it started with a $50 bass my dad brought from a Jewish synagogue that they used to have in my neighborhood. And he just told me to start playing, and I just kind of just said, okay, and you know what I mean? I started, you know, I really fell in love with it. It actually started with my twin sister was playing violin, but she wouldn't play it. So I would take it and play it sideways and break the string. So eventually they said, we need to get him an instrument, $50 bass. And then that basically is pretty much my dad handed my career to me, you know, with that instrument, which was a beat up. I mean, it was actually a cheap instrument, but it was an instrument. It was more than what I had.
Well, you didn't have
nothing. Yeah, it had nothing. And so, you know, with a lot of diligence and discipline, I've evolved to whoever I am today from a musical standpoint. Mm. You know, played in church, you know, really learned it in church. I'm a church baby, you know, out the gate. So that's where I learned, and you know what I'm saying, it just kind of went on and things started happening. As I got older in my teenage years, then I got to do a lot more professional work, and then it's, you know.
How old were you when you did your first professional gig?
Probably 16, 17, but I had been playing since I was about 9 or 10.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I used to do a lot of work with Northwestern Community Ensemble. They had a black ensemble that a guy named Walter Owens used to be over, and it was, you know, big thing. They'd have big concerts, and that was my first time kind of playing on stage, and then things kind of went from there, word of mouth, and then it went on to a lot of people in gospel music, which is where I got my start, from, you know, Yolanda Adams to Winans, BB&CC Commission, Fred Hammond, Thompson Community Singers, Milton Bronson, I mean, Shirley Caesar, Williams Brothers. I mean, I probably played with pretty much, you know, everybody. Commission, Fred Hammond.
Okay, yeah. That's a good thing. You mentioned Evanston. Where are you from?
Evanston. Yeah, I'm from Evanston. Grew up in Evanston.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you went to high school and everything
High
there.
School, yeah. One high school there.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Did you take music, study music, or anywhere?
No, I never, you know, took any formal classes. I pretty much learned by ear.
Okay.
So, you know, we had the big console in the living room. So, you know, when songs would come on, I would just try to mimic the song. So I ended up learning the hits by, not accident, but just kind of by ear.
Okay.
Then I'd take them notes and take them to church and, you know, add them into the gospel music. And, you know, we used to turn up back in the day, and that, you know, that's kind of how I learned.
Right. You know, it's great to know both. I wish I could play by ear. I think I tried to, but
yeah.
I do read a little bit.
Okay, you know? Okay.
I play bass a little bit.
Oh, cool, yeah.
for myself.
For yourself.
Play bass in the bass.
You play bass in the bass, mint.
But yeah, there you go.
But I would have loved to learn to read music. Things kind of took off for me, and that's something that I still could do. Yeah. But, I mean, I can hear a song, you know, one time and play it all the way through, you know. So that kind of a cheat code, but you know, that's just what it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Okay. I'd rather tell you what, we're gonna get back to some more music here on Classic Blues, because we'll be heading to the top of the hour in about 6 minutes here. So what you gonna do? You gonna take us to the top? You gonna want me to talk a little bit longer, or you wanna play something to take it to the top? Okay, he want me to keep talking.
All right.
Want me to talk to you.
All right. What else you wanna know?
I wanna know whatever, you know, you're the guest.
Okay.
You're in my living room.
Okay.
I don't want to hog the conversation. You tell us about you.
You got to ask me something now, because I might say something that's not copacetic, not, you know, not cool. So you better give me a little.
Okay. You got a website or something people can
on social media, all social media outlets, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. It's Steve Stone Huff. Same name on every social outlet you can get me.
And that's Steve Stone. And the stone is where did that come from, the stone?
That came from, you know, that's a kind of name that it was a company named Stone Productions, but it was taken from, you know, it's a spiritual connotation to that, meaning behind that. You know, the stone that the builders rejected become the head cornerstone. And you know, I based the company off of being a foundation, solid foundation, you know what I mean, reliable. And so people just start calling me, yo, Stone. So I kind of just started answering, and then Steve Stone came, and then Steve Stone Huff. So that's kind of where the name came from.
Okay, you're not a pitcher, you know, like the baseball player. Yeah, well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Now, how many instruments do you play?
Well, I can play keyboard. I started playing drums in church, and then from there, that's when the bass, my dad got me the bass, so I was kind of doing both, but eventually I evolved to bass. And then from bass and learning to play by ear, it's kind of relative to all instruments. So piano, you know, A, B, C, D, it, you know, it's still relative to what it is on bass, just like it is on a saxophone. So if you put an instrument in my hand and you give me a few minutes, I can pretty much figure it out. But keyboards, drums, guitar, bass, are what I play.
Okay.
You know, I'm not gonna pick a saxophone up, but if you give me 30 minutes, I can learn a song on saxophone too. So, you know what I'm saying?
I'll give you an hour, okay?
Give me an hour.
And you're a singer.
Well, I guess so.
Mm-hmm.
I was, you know, I was always demoing my music, the songs, as you know, as a songwriter and producer.
2 minutes to the top.
Before Avant would come, or Kiki Wyatt, or any of my artists I was working with, I would write a song and I would have to sing it. I would have to demo the song. And when I did Ron Isley and when I did Joe, those were two artists that told me, they said they think that, you know, I should think about doing an album. And that was 10 years ago, and I thought they were crazy, but I guess not.
Oh, okay, well, they've been around a little while.
Yeah.
Tell you what, we're going to get ready to go to the top of the hour, and we'll come back and we'll chat some more.
All right, let's do it.
All right, you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON 1690 AM.
Talk of Chicago and the voice of the nation. 1690 WVON, Berwyn, Chicago.
Special report, Hurricane Nate. I'm Barton Eckert. Hurricane Nate coming ashore again, second time tonight, this time near Biloxi, with winds of about 85 miles an hour. The second landfall for the quick-moving storm. Nate made an initial landfall at the mouth of the Mississippi River earlier on. The outer rings of the storm have been lashing the coastlines, bringing heavy rain and wind. Power outages have already begun to be reported in Alabama and Mississippi. Hurricane warnings and storm surge warnings are in effect for the Mississippi and Alabama coastlines. Meteorologist Ivan Cabrera.
That is literally the Gulf of Mexico moving in upwards of 4.5 feet as well across Lake Bourne. That's with that northerly wind on the southeastern lake east of Lake Pontchartrain. And then we have Pascagoula with 3.2 feet of storm surge coming in. These could go a little bit higher in the next hour or so.
Next, the center of the storm will move across the deep south. I'm Bart Neckert. A law enforcement official says investigators believe a note found in the Las Vegas shooter's hotel room contained a series of numbers that helped him calculate more precise shots. The official says the numbers included the distance between the high-rise hotel and Stephen Paddock was using as a perch and the concert the victims were attending. At a prayer service in Las Vegas, Vice President Mike Pence reached out saying, "In the depths of horror, Americans found hope in those who risked their lives after Sunday's mass shooting in the city.
Americans whose heroic actions in the face of unspeakable evil inspired the nation."
President Trump made a cryptic comment on Twitter about there being only one thing that will work in dealing with North Korea. He left us hanging on what that is. I'm Bart Neckert.
You're listening to Love Advice with Leanne. Caller, you're on the air.
Hi, Leanne. Longtime listener, first-time caller. Why, in your professional opinion, do you never take my calls off the air?
Is this Carl?
Yep, it's Carl. I mean, we had a few dates. Everything was great, I thought.
Well, you know, when you switch to GEICO, you could save a lot of money on car insurance.
Okay, awesome.
You should call them.
I will.
GEICO, because saving 15% or more on car insurance is always a great answer.
Guarantees to get that timeshare off your hands and out of your life, or you don't pay. That's right, they'll do a free case review for you. It's legal, it's permanent, and the moment that timeshare is gone, you can start planning the getaway you really want. 2018's maintenance fee bill will arrive any day now. Get out now before you pay that fee. Visit resortrelease.com or call them at 888-308-5955 to see if you qualify. That's 888-308-5955. Call now.
Quarterback Colin Kaepernick.
Colin Kaepernick.
Colin Kaepernick.
Colin Kaepernick kneeling to protest social injustice and police brutality.
Yes, I'll continue to sit. I'm going to continue to stand with the people that are being oppressed. To me, this is something that has to change. And when there's significant change and I feel like that flag represents what it's supposed to represent, and this country is representing people the way that it's supposed to, I'll stand.
The Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
Join WVON as we celebrate the induction of our very own legendary Purvis Spann into the Chicago Blues Hall of Fame. Purvis Spann, affectionately known as the Blues Man, is the co-founder of Midway Broadcasting, the parent company of WVON. You are invited to enjoy an evening of blues as we celebrate him and several other local blues greats on Sunday, October 15th at Buddy Guy's, 700 South Wabash Avenue. Come out for a night of fun, music, and a funky good time. Celebrate the blues Sunday, October 15th from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. at Buddy Guy's, 700 South Wabash. For tickets, go to buddyguy.com or call 312-427-1190. That's 312-427-1190.
All my daddy's records.
Well, we found them right here weeknights on 1690 WVON. On the B-Sides with Insane Wayne from midnight to 3 a.m. on 1690 WVON. You'll never have to look for your records again.
Hi, I'm Sir Henry Cheatham, inviting you to join us every Saturday night from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. for some great American music and fun right here on Classic Blues and R&B. We serve our beer cold, our iced tea sweet, our chicken wings are fried, and we have some great barbecue, too, along with our homemade brew. All of it waiting just for you here at the Classic Blues Juke Joint. Join us Saturday nights from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. here on the Talk of Chicago and the Voice of the Nation, 1690 a.m. WVON.
Men never think of breast cancer as a manly disease. But ask the men who suffer with it. Real men think pink.
Live from the Xfinity Studios at WVON. You're listening to Night Blues with Sir Henry Cheatham on 1690, The Talk of Chicago.
All right, here we go. Sunday morning here on Classic Blues and R&B on WVON 1690 AM. We're streaming live at WVON.com on the World Wide Web, and we're also at iHeartRadio, and we're up and running on Ustream. You can get your chance to see some beautiful sunrise of chocolate. He's looking over there at it, you know, good-looking guy, you know. I mean, he thinks so, you know.
Dripping.
You know, yeah.
Dripping chocolate.
There you go. Yeah, because it is a little warm up in here.
Yeah. I'm trying to bring the heat.
Yeah, that's what it is, you know.
Yeah.
WVON, I always want you to get social by going to facebook.com/WVON1690. Follow us on Twitter at WVON1690 and on Instagram at WVON1690. You can always text WVON to 88474. And you can reach us in the studio at 773-591-1690. And I'm waiting on you to call me, Brian Peoples. Kindly give me a call. Ring that bell for us. Want to hear from you, son. We've got something we want to tell you. It's good news for you. And Classic Blues, want you to also go to facebook.com/ and like us over there, Classic Blues and R&B. Follow us on Twitter at WVON Henry. And you know what? We want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel at Henry CB. Glad to have you there. Saturday, October 28th is the first ever WVON Family Care Expo. It's a one-day auction, action-packed resource fair and forum. From finances to education, health care, we will cover it all. Over 40 exhibitors to give you some the benefit of their benefits for the entire family. And a save the date, that's October 28th, and plan to attend. More details are coming soon. Now you do that now. You be listening, you stick around and listen for that, okay? Mumford-Port Marine Association wants you guys to come over and get involved with them. They're located at 7011 South Vincennes Avenue here in Chicago. And their phone number is 773-873-6600. That's 773-873-6600. I want you to come over and support them. It's a veteran center. And us veterans need your support. But guess what? They're trying to send y'all to war again. I don't have to go. I'm done, man. My musket is put up, you know. The National Women Veterans United Community Center wants you ladies to get involved with them at 7907 South Racine Avenue in Chicago here. They will let you explain your benefits to your ladies, that you've been into the military, you've done your thing, and there's certain things you're entitled to, so they want to explain it to you, and they need your support with your organization. The office number is 872-731-2150. The website is nwvu.org. Email is ladyvetch2@yahoo.com. Okay, now you're up to date. I just informed you of everything that's going on in the whole wide world. We got a studio guest here, Mr. Steve Stone Huff.
Yes, sir. Happy to be here.
Are you related to a guy named Phil Huff?
You know, we talk. Yeah, we talk on Instagram. I mean, on Facebook all the time. You know, but I don't know if we're really related. But we act like we are.
Yeah, you don't know that side of the Huff yet.
Yeah, we call one another cuz, but you know what I'm saying. We gonna figure it out.
Yeah, I got that. You know, that's on Facebook. Only Cheatums I used to know were my family.
Okay.
I get on Facebook. I said, damn, where these Cheatums come from?
Yeah, you Cheatums know? All over the place.
Yeah, you look up, I said, dog. Cause you know,
your illegitimate kids? Or your,
well, no, they ain't mine. Now. They my
secret children.
No, they're not mine. My daddy never told me I had any more sisters and brothers outside of the 10 that we are.
Okay,
know?
All right.
So I don't know, you know.
No, I feel you. Cheatums come up, huh? A lot of Cheatums.
Yeah. Damn, where did they come from? Mm. I mean, we discussed it among ourselves. The family said, where did they come from?
Yeah.
We didn't know any other Cheatums, you know, but the ones in our immediate family.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So tell us a little bit more about you there, Thee.
If you haven't heard, my album release party, I promise, album release party is going to be this Wednesday, October 11th at the Promontory. Special guest is Avant. A lot of other special guests that are going to be there. Great musical night. We're going to have a good time. And, you know, I'm going to sing a number of songs from my album. And then Avant, you know, is going to do a few songs. And a couple other people are going to do songs. And we're going to have a really good time.
How many CDs do you have? Is this your first one or what?
This is my first one. Yeah. Okay. This record was like the culmination of my life, of career, you know, for the people I've written for, the ups, the downs, relationship, divorce, just the good, the bad, my spiritual side, all of these things. This record is, I would say, just, a tapestry of all of those things. I think I'm going to do another one. You know, it's been doing pretty well. So I moved into artist category this year. But this is the first record. Okay. I promise. You know, you can get it on all digital outlets now. And I'll have physical CDs also at the event at the Promontory on Wednesday.
Mm. What you enjoy doing most, writing, singing, producing, or what?
I think producing, I really enjoy. I think maybe just the production and writing side. Like if it's an artist I have in mind, I can write a song for that artist. Or sometimes if it's just, you know, me just creating tracks. But ultimately, you know, just producing the entire product from beginning to end, I think is what I love the most.
Who have you seen? Name some of the artists you've written for.
Written for Fred Hammond, Mary, this is some gospel stuff, the Thompson Community Singers, a bunch of people, but on the R&B side, Avant, his first three platinum albums, his first three, Kiki Wyatt, responsible for Kiki Wyatt's first album, platinum, Charlie Wilson, Joe, the Isley Brothers. I worked with the OJs. I worked with Kelly Rowland. I worked with Teddy Riley, R. Kelly, of course, and Shante Moore. The list is pretty long, you know. So I've been blessed. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Keith Sweat, Keith Sweat too. Keith Sweat. We can't forget him, baby.
Why is that?
No, I worked with Keith Sweat too. Yeah.
Now, they all have had at least somebody, you know, they've been there. They all have had a record on the radio and played along. You know?
Yeah,
so, that's a good track record.
Yeah.
Man, you know, So you've been writing that long time.
Yeah, I've been writing a long time, about 20 years.
Okay. Yeah. You don't look like you're no more than 50.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to get back to some more music. We'll talk to our guests as we continue along the program here. All right, you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON 1690 AM.
Have a little fun. something we need to tell you. In your life, you're gonna work for everything you get. Nobody owes you nothing. Don't you ever forget. Mother Soul was right.
Did you want a cut? What a cut too, because
since I was three. I played Montreal, Canada.
Give you the love.
Took it all the way down to New Orleans. Back up to Memphis, Tennessee. Jumped across to Arkansas. Played a high school gym in McGee.
Mother Soul was right. Three is hashtag DWTS. Netflix and chill. Netflix and chill.
Tight. Whoa. I go by the name, it'll be an overdose. Wicked white women, ladies, and you know we do the most. So go on, get it up, I wanna see you touch some toes. Can you bring it in a circle? It's looking real decent, let me see about the thing. Girl, bust a bigger booty, coke bottle frame, shorty. And I love the way you move it, bend it over, shake it, baby, like a stripper, how she do it? All the ladies in the club tonight, let me see you tambourine, shake it, for me can ride, yeah. All the ladies in the club tonight, let me see you tambourine, shake it, for me can ride, go.
Let me see you bounce, oh, come on, on your toes. Let me see you do it, do it, do it. Let me see you bounce it. Let me see you bounce on your toes. Make it bounce, baby. I like it.
This is Music with a Feeling on Classic Blues and R&B, WVON 1690.
Dance on, all right, come on, get your dance.
For the second, so I'm coming to you.
You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON 1690 AM. We come to you every Saturday night, Sunday morning, right here. And we start at 11 p.m. You can get aboard the Classic Blues Express. It's nice and big old, nice, comfortable seats. And you can ride with us until 2 o'clock, 2 a.m. in the morning here on Classic Blues and R&B. I want you to remember, ignorance is the most costly crop that any community can produce, folks. Mr. Williams said that in 1918, and we'll be celebrating that next year on his birthday, maybe. Yeah, we'll celebrate that next year. Ignorance is the most costly crop that anyone, any community can produce, you know. I didn't talk about the thing in Vegas, you know, which is there is no place in a civilized society, for anyone to have, you know, assault weapons. Assault weapons, I'm a veteran, so assault weapons are, you know, they're used in combat. So who are we fighting? Each other, you know? I mean, it's obviously this bastard decided that he was gonna do what he decided to do. He had nothing else to do, man. And, something has to be done. You know, these guys, y'all all picking on Trump. Y'all all picking on President Trump. But folks, there are 535 folks who are responsible for our safety, our, you know, our well-being. Those congressmen and senators, those are the people who represent us. President Trump does not represent us as lawmakers. But these guys, if they want to do something about it, they can do it. And I don't think any sane country, any country with any sense, yeah, we're the only one going up around with all this craziness. You go to Afghanistan, well, hell, they're in a war, you know, so therefore they have a right to have it, you know, because, hey, they. But anyway, we got some serious problems, you know. Now, I don't think we're going to war with Korea, but I think most of y'all think we are. I hope not, anyway. Just heard you just heard our studio guest, Mr. Steve Stonehuff, and Get Your Dancing with the Stars. And you heard Ms. UV Hayes, Get Your Dance On. Ricky White, Bounce. Jamai Rogers, Parental Advice. Grady Champion, and Heels and Hip, all right here on Classic Blues and R&B. Tell me this, brother.
Yes.
This Dancing with the Stars.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What is that about? Did they come about the TV show, or did it came before or after?
It actually came. It came after, but you know, whenever you look at the stars from above or beneath, okay, you know, there's something, you know, very mystical, and you know, it just kind of takes you away. It's a good feeling, you know,
yeah, yeah.
And it like kind of takes you away from the current madness, you know, when you look up at the stars, something happened, and so, you know. In writing that song, I kind of wanted to give people that kind of feeling, you know, just to come away from it all, come away from whatever negative or problems or issues that you might be having, and just take a two-step, you know what I mean, and dance, and hopefully, like, it could give you that feeling of, like, looking at the stars.
So it had nothing to do with the so-called motion picture star. I ain't gonna say movies. Movies, they had nothing to do with that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, no. I was just writing and singing, and you know, and afterwards, and I thought, I said, man, this kind of goes with the show. It would be great. You know, maybe a year or so, or maybe, you know, 5 years or so, it could easily end up on the show. Anything mm-hmm. can happen. So we'll see. Everybody's like, did you write it for the show? Are you gonna have it on the show? But that's something that could possibly happen. That would be great if it did happen. So we'll see.
That is kind of a Steppers song, right?
That's a Steppers. That's definitely, it's soul music, but it's R&B, but it's definitely a Steppers cut. Yeah. You know, we're going to be doing that at the release party this Wednesday at the Promontory, October 11th, with special guest Devon and so many others. So I'll be performing that there as well.
Now, you got your own band, or you...
Yeah, I've got probably the cream of the crop, the OG, triple OG gods of all the musicians that are out now. Percy Beatty on keyboards, Richard Gibbs on keyboards, Philip Patterson, who was with you last week, on keyboards, Greg Lanfair on guitar, Al Willis on guitar, Maurice Mofitz Fitzgerald on bass, Kevin Brunson on drums. So I don't know what to tell you. You get all those guys in one place at one time, you know, that's showing a lot of love. I'm humbled. Those guys raised me. And they said, hey, you know, we'll do the release party. So I hope everybody will come out Wednesday.
the Promontory.
The 11th, yes, at the Promontory.
What happened? You're not good enough to play bass?
You know what? I'm gonna play a few things. I'm gonna pull out little tricks out my, you know what I'm saying, about the stash.
Yeah.
You know, be surprised. I'm gonna do a little something. We'll see what happens.
That's good. Sounds mm-hmm. good. But you're gonna be on that bass, man. Keyboard, but basically you're gonna be singing.
I'll be singing. Singing and dancing, and you know what I mean, doing my thing.
Now, do you work with Mary? Are they still doing? I mean, I see they got a radio show or something. I don't
uh-huh.
know.
Yeah.
Are you still working with them?
No. I did a song on the album. It went platinum. It was called, the song I did was called, I'm sorry. I can't remember right now. But they're still, they haven't done the album in a minute. But I've worked with them, played with them, you know, live a couple times. Really, really cool people.
Now, are you doing a lot of singing? or a lot of playing or both?
On this album?
The period, or? I mean your performance.
Oh yeah, perform all singing, yeah. All songs I wrote, produced, arranged, and I'm be singing all, you know what I'm saying, the whole night. Be at the microphone.
Okay, what kind of tour date you got coming up? You got a big tour date?
We're working on tour dates now, working on setting up the tour, actually. But I've done some like spot dates in Atlanta, in Georgia. I've done a couple things here, City Winery in Atlanta, done Columbus, Georgia, a couple shows here. And, you know, shows are coming in, so.
That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's another question I was going to ask you about your hard work, I guess, has escaped me when you started. You answered it, but I guess already. I'm not sure exactly which one it was. You know? But anyway, we'll get to it.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, I just had a birthday, okay?
Happy birthday to you. What you make? What's the...
7'4".
7'4".
Yes, sir. Yes,
oh,
sir.
Man. You look awesome. You don't look nowhere near that.
That's all right. Don't worry about what it looks like.
It
you can't see too well.
Oh, yeah. Congratulations.
Hey, thank you, man. Yeah, it's a great thing. Intend to have a big bash next year.
Okay.
For the year after that.
Okay. Let me know now. I'll come sing for you now.
Okay.
I'm playing. I come play for you, too.
Okay. All right. Okay, we're going to get back to some more music here on Classic Blues and R&B. You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here. Our studio guest is Mr. Steve Stone Huff.
Yes, sir.
Here's a song from the request line.
Can't be choosy, I know. That's what the people say. But though my heart is begging for love, I've turned some love away. Oh, maybe one was true love. I'll never know which, 'cause your love is the only love to make this beggar rich. I'm a choosy beggar, and you're my choice, baby.
You're my choice.
Well, now people say you can't have your cake and then eat it too. They tell me that I'm making a mistake.
Try to do right. Remember I warned and I told you these words. right to try to do right, baby. Yeah. You've done me wrong for the last time. And when I leave you this time, baby, yeah, I don't care what I leave behind. There ain't no need in you doing me like you're doing, baby, no.
I should play it next then.
Oh,
But you got 2 minutes to talk.
All right, you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B. Just heard the studio guest, Mr. Steve Stone Huff. Netflix and Chill, that's the name of that. And you also heard Miss Melba Moore, You Stepped Into My Life. Willie White, Do Your, no, it wasn't Do Your Thing. What the hell was it? It's just Too Late. What the hell was the name of that thing?
What the hell was
it? Yeah. It's Too Late. That's what it was. Late. I got written one thing and he played another song, right? Now, you say you work with Joe, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I remember Tyrone talking about Joe. He's out of St. Louis somewhere, right?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, right. So is he still doing a lot of work?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, he just had a big tour with Charlie Wilson.
Okay, he was on that tour with Charlie.
Yeah, he was on that with Charlie, okay. And he just dropped an album. Okay. Well, not just dropped an album, but he had a big song this summer.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And who's your manager? Who does your
Eric,
manager?
Eric Payton, yeah.
Oh, Eric Payton is your
uh-huh.
manager.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Right, security.
You can call
the security.
Hey, that's a good thing. So he does the booking for you.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good thing. Have you guys been together a while?
Yes, okay. from the beginning of the production with Avant, he actually brought Avant to me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, let me hear him, and we recorded him, put him out in the whole nine.
Right, he was telling his father had the brass...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the brass ready. Yeah, remember that, yeah. Well, that's where we used to be able to cut our chops at a lot of these places,
mm-hmm.
you know? Yeah, but now that Netflix and Chill, why you name that?
Netflix and Chill is about, you know, it's about it's about looking at, you know, movies and series and chilling, you know, with a female.
Oh, okay. Well,
you know, because instead of like just watching one show, you get a whole series. Or you can watch a movie, but it's, you know what I'm saying, your girlfriend, you know, your wife or somebody you were trying to get to know a little bit better. You know, you can watch it at home now.
Mm. And you can get to know them a little bit.
You can get a rollover. I mean, you can get to... know them a little bit better.
Right.
Yeah, you know, if you have, you know, we had the right things there, you know, good movie.
1 minute to the top.
Okay.
So it's just a way to kick off a little nice little night, you know.
Good, good.
Yeah.
I want to thank you again for being with us.
Man, I thank you for having me.
And tell the folks, you're the Thursday night where?
Wednesday night at the Promontory. I Promise album release party, special guest, Avant. So many others are going to be there. We're going to have a great night. It's Wednesday night, hump day, you know, excitement. So we're going to starts at 7. Over at 11, we're going to start on time, end on time, but it's going to be great. I hope everybody can make it out. Tickets at PromontoryChicago.com.
All right. Well, I want to thank you very much for being a guest here, and I want to thank the one and only Miss Wilma Vento for beating me to death and make sure I got you. All right. You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B. We're going to the top. We'll be back.
Talk of Chicago and the voice of the nation. 1690 WVON, Berwyn, Chicago.
Special report, Hurricane Nate. The storm surge from Hurricane Nate is picking up as the Category 1 storm has made a second landfall on the Mississippi coast. Biloxi getting the brunt of the storm at this point, but hurricane warnings and storm surge warnings are in effect for the entire Mississippi and Alabama coastlines. Meteorologist Ivan Cabrera on the big problem at this hour.
Gulf of Mexico basically overtaking some areas here, including Highway 90. Emergency responders reporting dozens of roads underwater at this hour, as you would expect.
Michael Weierstadt is the fire chief in Gulfport, Mississippi. He talks about whether the people of the city were blessed this time around.
Oh, definitely. We feel blessed that it looks like at this point, you know, it hasn't been near as bad as what it definitely could have been. So we're definitely feeling blessed this time.
Mm. I'm Barton Eckert. NBC's Saturday Night Live.
In a world that keeps on pushing me around,
paying tribute to the victims of the Las Vegas mass shooting and the late rock superstar Tom Petty as well by opening the show on Saturday night with country star Jason Aldean singing one of Petty's songs. Aldean performed I Won't Back Down during the live opening and then introduced the show. Aldean was performing at an outdoor concert in Vegas when that gunman fired on the crowd from a high-rise building, killing 58 people. Petty died the next day in Los Angeles from cardiac arrest. Protesters rallying across Russia in a challenge to President Putin on his 65th birthday and to pressure authorities into letting opposition leaders enter the presidential race. I'm Barton Eckert.
Okay, keep your eyes closed.
Okay.
I want to show you my first ever painting.
All right.
Okay. Open your eyes.
Oh, that's a lot of colors and shapes.
So be honest. What do you think?
Well, I like how if you switch to Geico, you could save hundreds of dollars on car insurance.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah. Here, why don't I hold your paintbrush while you call them?
Geico, because saving 15% or more on car insurance is always a great answer.
Is credit card debt ruining your life? Now you can have a large portion of your credit card debt forgiven. Get Relief Today wants to give you free information that shows you how. This program is proven to work for credit card debt, medical bills, and department store debt. We'll give you the secret to this money-saving program absolutely free. 800-207-8558. That's 800-207-8558. That's 800-207-8558.
Our Caregivers Expo was a huge success, but we know there are other concerns facing our families, and on Saturday, October 28th, WVON will address them. It's our first ever Family Care Expo, a one-day, action-packed resource fair and forum designed to provide you with the information, resources, and products you need to create a better future for you and your family. From finances to education to healthcare, we're focusing on all of them, and there'll be 40 exhibitors offering helpful resources to benefit the entire family. On October 28th at Malcolm X College, WVON, in conjunction with our sister station WRLL and Relevant Marketing, is taking care of our family's business at our first ever Family Care Expo. Keep listening for more details.
Hey, there he is. How's it going?
I'm having a stroke.
Are you going to shake my hand or what?
I'm having a stroke.
Wow, you're not even moving your arm.
I'm having a stroke.
Are you okay?
I'm having a stroke.
Your face looks weird, too.
I'm having a stroke.
Are you having a seizure or something?
I'm having a stroke.
When someone is having a stroke, they may not be able to say it with words, but their body language will tell you loud and clear.
I'm having a stroke.
You just need to know the sudden signs. Look for FAST, F-A-S-T. F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. Or S, speech difficulty. Then T, time. Time to call 911 immediately, because the sooner they get to the hospital, the sooner they'll get treatment. And that can make a remarkable difference in their recovery. Know the sudden signs. Face, arm, speech, time. Spot a stroke fast. Visit strokeassociation.org. Brought to you by the American Stroke Association and the Ad Council.
Hi, I'm James H. Owens. My wife Caroline and I, we're the proprietors of Divine Healing Herbs. We're located at 1621 West on 87th Street, right here in Chicago, Illinois. You can call us at 773-233-4372. Join us every Sunday morning at 6 a.m. as we discuss the latest trends in your health and nutritional needs. We'll take your calls on herbs, natural healing, and detoxifying. It's the Divine Healing Herbs Hour, every Sunday at 6 a.m. on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 a.m., WVON.
Hello, I'm Sir Henry Cheatham, inviting you, Mary, Margaret, Elizabeth, Sally, Felicia, and Sue, along with Makita, Lakeisha, and all of the senoritas, too, to our Saturday night juke joint, classic blues and R&B, here on AM 1690 WVON. And don't forget to bring Byron, Henry, Leroy, Warren, Delmar, and Ray Ray, too. Join us here every Saturday night at 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. on the Talk of Chicago and the Voice of the Nation, AM 1690 WVON.
My October checklist. Rake leaves? Check. Change my fall wardrobe? Check. Oh, change battery in smoke detectors? Check. And schedule my mammogram? Hashtag think pink.
Live from the Xfinity Studios at WVON.
We're your original social media.
You're listening to Night Blues with Sir Henry Cheatham on 1690, The Talk of Chicago.
All right, here we go into the final hour here for this week of classic blues and R&B. As I said every week, don't forget now, ignorance is the most costly crop that any community can produce. And when you do that, you get ignorance. That's what you get, folks, and nothing more. And everything is just lousy. We're streaming live at WVON.com on the World Wide Web. And we're at iHeartRadio. You can always get us here at WVON, 1690 AM, too. You can get us there as well. And we want you to get social with us by going to facebook.com/WVON1690. We want you to follow us on Twitter at WVON1690 and on Instagram at WVON1690. Classic Blues wants you to get social with us as well by going to facebook.com, Classic Blues and RB, and follow us on Twitter at WVON Henry. I want you to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. And subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com. And then you just type in the old name, Henry CB. Yes, you do that, and we will we'll be laughing. We'll be glad to get you to do that for us, you know. Saturday, October 28th is the first ever WVON Family Care Expo. It's one day. It's a one day of action-packed resources and a fair, resource fair and a forum. You know, you ask your questions and check out a lot of things there. You can get there from finances to education to health care. We'll be covering it all. Over 40 exhibitors to benefit the entire family. Save the date. That's October 28th, and plan to attend. More details are on their way. They're working it out. So once they get it all worked out, they'll share it with me, I guess, and I'll share it with you. Join our Chat Daddy Sims for the Monday night edition of Real Talk, Real People. Chat Daddy and his crew will debate the age-old issue of to celebrate or not to celebrate Columbus Day. That's the question. Exploring the multi-faceted world of professional nursing, professional nursing industry, all this and so much more at 6 p.m. on your favorite happy hour on the radio. Real talk, real people with Art Chit Chat Daddy Sims. All right, we listen to music here on the program as we continue to roll right along. And you know what I want to hear, son? You know, you want to know what I want to hear? You want to know, right? I want to hear Tommy Cashflow. What you got to say?
You know, I don't know. He'll be covered up soon.
I don't know. You kind of coming through a little distorted. I don't know if it's my ears or what, you know. All right, so you're going to give it to me, huh?
Soon.
But you're not going to go by my list, huh?
Soon.
You're in charge, right? You're the big shot. Okay, you're the big shot. Do what you want to do, though, okay? All right, you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON, 1690 AM. I got a couple of guests here, too. Joshua, who's a future drummer. Yeah, Joshua Vento, he's a future drummer. He's going to be coming back on the show in a couple of years telling me about the great tours and all of that stuff and how he's doing in the percussion area. All right, you're listening to the Classic Blues and R&B on WVON 1690 AM.
Here's a song from the request line.
Don't cry no more. Wipe away your tears. Don't cry no more, baby. Wipe away your tears. And I know. That your love is real. Don't cry. I'm begging you. Don't cry no more, baby. I'm begging you. Every tear you shed, tell me that your love is true. Without a doubt that you really, really, really love me.
summertime, and the living is easy.
Here's a song from the request line.
Hi, this is recording artist Sir Jonathan Burton, and you're listening to Classic Blues and R&B with Sir Henry Cheatham on AM 1690 WBON. Lock it in.
Found you.
And I'm
ain't so greedy. But your love made me needy. I'm selfish, I'm selfish. I want you to myself. I'm selfish, I'm selfish. I ain't gonna share you with no one else.
Hey, this is Tommy Castro. Here's a song from my brand new record, Method to My Madness.
We'll be right back. Sir Henry, hit me with some old school music.
Here's a song from the request line.
You go back on there. When you go back on there. It's in there. You got to go down. Go down on the list. It's on there.
And you're gonna cry, 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 cry all
WVON makes the week go fast, makes the weekend last and last. WVON.
Spend your Saturday nights right here on Classic Blues and R&B with Sir Henry Cheatham.
On the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
You know the time have come. Oh, for me to hit the road again.
All right there, you just heard my man howl and woof going down that great highway 49. 40, what the hell is W, right? 49, I think they 49W or some crap. They're not north-south, but they are north-south streets, you know. But, yep, that's, take you right there. And you heard Rich Astley, never gonna give you up. That's one out for my little friend, a future drummer. You know, he's a... gonna be a drummer, and he's here in the studio, and he wanted to hear that, so we played that for him. Also, you heard Paul Richmond, "I'm Selfish." That's from my girl, Miss Florence Nightingale Watson. I don't know why I call you Nightingale. You ain't no nurse. And Mary Wells, "Two Lovers." That's one after Miss Alice, who's also in the studio here with me. She wanted to hear Miss. Mary Wells, who was a very good singer, you know. Mary Wells should have been on the top tier there, but, you know, politics have always played away. They're not all about talent, you know. And then Dinah Ross was the one that they shot out there. So she became the face of Motown. And you heard Alexander O'Neill, "Sunshine." That went out from a man over there. He decided he wanted to hear Alexander O'Neill. I didn't know he could pick that kind of good music. You know, he's a hip hopper.
I like good music.
Hey, man, I'm just kidding, man. You're not a hip hopper, man. I'm just kidding, man. He learned a little bit since he's been on the show. So, Yeah, so you heard the impression, You'll Want Me Back, and you heard Smokey. Y'all here on Clay. Bobby Bland, that went out for Miss Kim Mills, am I right? Miss Kim Mills, that was from your husband there. Anyway, you listen to Classic Blues and R&B, folks. We enjoyed the program. Hope you enjoyed it, too. So you also heard Tommy Castro, Common Ground, from his CD, Method to My Madness. Tommy doing some pretty good stuff, you know. I see a couple of Spanish names out there from the Northwest that are doing some pretty good music, folks. And I'm not jive, you not, you know. Yeah, he's going to be in town somewhere soon, too. I think he could be out in Berwyn out there coming up. You know, he's an alligator recording artist, you know. He's going to be out there doing his thing out there in Fitzgerald, I think, one of the places out there in the West. Yeah, but I want to say hello to my friend, Officer Jones, and his wife, Miss Michelle Jones. Hope you guys are doing well. And all of my homeboys and girls down there in the great state of Mississippi. My brother Walter, I know you probably went to sleep on me, but I'm going to say it to you anyway. I'll probably send you this clip, okay? Happy birthday, man. I know your birthday is coming up to the 10th, whenever the hell that is. That's Thursday, right? I think it's Thursday, am I right? Hey, come on, help me out. Thursday, what is the 10th? No, the 10th is Tuesday. Yeah, that's right, Tuesday. Yeah, you got a birthday coming up Tuesday, so... I'm gonna send this to you. In fact, what I'm gonna do, hey, you know what I want you to do? Find me Solomon Burke. Happy birthday. Yeah, do that. That's going out for me and all the rest of the folks who had a birthday in October. Yeah, that's a good one. You know what I'm saying? And when you get it, throw that old finger up. Thumb. Give me the thumb. I don't want you just throwing up any finger now. You gotta make sure you find it for me. And say, hey, I got it. You know, once you say that, you know, hey. And I'll shut my mouth, quit talking. You know, be quiet for a while. Say hello to my man Solomon out there in Colorado and Luis Ruiz out there in Colorado. So how do you guys out there in?
I got it.
Right in Colorado. And Chief up there in South Dakota, thank you for wishing me a happy birthday, Chief. Brother Alex Looking Elk. And he's a real chief, folks. So he's not a phony chief. All right, here we go. You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B here on WVON 1690 AM.
Oh, yeah. Oh, today is your birthday, and I wish you many, many, many more. Oh, today is a special day, one you never had before. I'll send you flowers by the hour, candy and perfume. I'm gonna shower you, precious baby, birthday baby, tonight. Oh, today is your birthday. I wish you many, many, many more. Oh, today is a special day, one you never had before. I'll send you flowers by the hour, with candy and perfume. I'm gonna shower you, pretty baby, birthday baby, tonight. Had before. I'll send you flowers.
by the hour. With candy and perfume, I'm gonna shower you. Pretty baby, birthday baby, tonight. Everybody sing with me now.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Just for the birthday people.
Happy birthday, happy
everybody,
birthday.
Everybody, everybody, everybody.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Happy.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
I want you to be happy, baby.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Will you clap your hands for me? Get happy, y'all.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Happy, happy, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy,
happy
birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy, 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 happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy, happy, happy special day.
Happy birthday.
Happy, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
You're listening to Classic Blues and R&B with Sir Henry.
This is Classic Blues.
Classic Blues. Classic Blues.
And R&B.
Today we have a guest on the line. It's Big Lou Double L Johnson. Brother Lou, how you doing?
Laughing at my name is. Are you laughing at my name? Why are you laughing, Brother Henry?
No, I was butchering it. I wasn't trying to butcher it.
Don't butcher my name, man. That L, that extra L in my name stands for my peoples, my ancestors.
All right. Yeah. So, you know, it's just like, you know, coming from down south, you know, what's your name? Double L. You know, it's WL, right? It's a double L. So, Brother Lou, welcome to the show. How you doing?
I'm all right for old fat man. I'm just going back and forth right now from my computer to my room in here where I'm speaking to you in my booth. But I'm good.
Good.
There's so much stuff going on, man. I'm like running around like a chicken with his head cut off.
Well, you might be a chicken. Since you got your head cut off, you don't know who you are. Brother Lou, tell us a little bit about you and who you are.
Good lad, man. I'm just a poor boy from the west side of Chicago, not far from the original WVON studios, man, over there on Roosevelt, California.
Okay.
And, yeah, grew up on the west side over there, went to Westinghouse High School and then Columbia College. And after that, I had me a business for a few years representing actors and models. And then I decided to go the blues route, and I've been doing that ever since, man. It's been good. The blues been very good to Big Lou.
And that's a good thing. I'm glad to hear that, you know. I love it myself too, Brother Lou.
I'm glad it's good to somebody because, you know, someday you say having the blues ain't necessarily a good thing, but having the blues for me has been a blessing, baby.
Right, yeah, a lot of folks think the blues is, I don't see it as depressing either, Brother Lou.
You know I got put, they're going to be putting me in the Chicago Blues Hall of Fame.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly right.
That's an honor and a half. But I got a date with Big Lou, Big Lou's Bluesville Review. We'd already been contracted to perform at the Arizona Southern Heritage Blues Festival in Tucson, Arizona. So I ain't going to be able to come. I'm going to have to, like, send a video and maybe my wife or somebody like that to come accept in my stead.
Mm-hmm.
But after that, the next month, we're going to be working on our album. You know, we got some Chicago cats on it and some of my old friends and some new music that's been written for me and some stuff I've written myself, and we're looking forward to finishing it up.
That's a good thing. Sounds good.
This is Classic Blues and R&B.
You're listening to Sir Henry Cheatham on Classic Blues and R&B.
Got this thing coming up. All righty, okay, here it is. My man here threw the old Q song on me here, and I got to be ready for it. I'm glad I heard it, you know. Hey, like I say, welcome back, man. I never thought I'd miss you as much. What you got to say? You got something to say? I don't hear you. Whatever you say, I miss you, not Ed. Your mic is not coming through. Anyway,
you said it all. That's all, basically.
Say again.
You said it all, basically.
Oh, I said. Oh, I didn't know. I said hell. I knew normally you don't agree with me. You don't agree with me.
I do. Yes, I do. That's why I'm not saying nothing.
Okay. So I won that round. That's good. I'm glad I won a round. Anyway, you just heard an interview with Big Lou Johnson. Big Lou would be inducted into the Chicago Blues Hall of Fame coming up next Sunday at Buddy Guy's. You can get your tickets at Buddy Guy's. And the boss man, Mr. Purvis Spann, will get the Pioneer Award. He'll be he and Mr. Herman Roberts. They will both be inducted there, which is a good thing to see those gentlemen who have really done a great deal, you know, in town for this great music. They both will be in the Pioneer induction coming up at Buddy Guy. Hope that you can get out there and check it out. You know, Big Lou will be being inducted. He's a blues singer. He's from Chicago, yeah. He's out there on the West Coast. And trying to some of the inductees would be Pioneer Award, as I say, would be Pervis Spann, the blues man. Herman Roberts for Roberts Motel. Little Walter's daughter will be receiving an award on her on his behalf. Melody would be picking it up for Mr. Spann. Eddie C. Campbell, he's a legend in the blues. Holly V. Maxwell, Gene Daddy G. Barge, Carl Weathersby, Big Lou Johnson, I just told you, Barry Goldberg. All of these and a lot of more people would be there. But anyway, it would be coming up on Sunday, October, I think that's 14, October 14th. And Buddy Guys is located at 700 South Wabash. It's October 15th, and it starts at 2 o'clock, 2 p.m. until 8 o'clock. I've made a couple of them. It's a nice place to be. Excuse me. So, anyway, but I'm very proud to see that the Boss Man is going in finally. I've been talking to my man Garland. He said, how the devil can we have this without having Spann involved? Anyway, I want to thank all of you for joining us here tonight. Hope to get back up in here next Saturday, Sunday, for you to be here with us for another great show of American music, classic blues and R&B. I want to thank Ricardo Bento, his wife, Miss Wilma, and my friend, my new friend, Miss Alice, and Brother Joshua. For being in here. Joshua wanted to hear that song about the little English group, so he's happy. So I'm going to try to get him so he'll be listening to this great music when he plays drums and all. Remember, folks, that ignorance is the most costly crop that any community can produce. And until next week, may God bless and keep you, and hopefully we will not have any tragedies, folks. We will not have anybody shooting and blowing up the country or blowing up some other country. I think, as I said before, I think the president is selling Wolf tickets, and hey, Kim ain't got no choice but to sell them back. Hopefully they don't cash in on them. Until next week, may God bless and keep you. Adios.
Talk of Chicago and the voice of the nation. 1690 WVON, Berwyn, Chicago.
Special report, Hurricane Nate. Hurricane Nate continues to rapidly move inland. Latest update from the National Weather Service shows the